Yes, we were discussing the analysis and application, understanding capacity, critical approach, and why, what, and where. Where is the law? What is the law? And how this law is there? And what should be there? These are the questions. And these questions should be understood by all the student by application of own mind as the student of PG. Please mind it. And the provision which is written under section 4 and the same some provisions are written here under section 9. So what's the reason? And some are written under section 5. Again, some aspect is written here under this aspect, what's the reason? The reason you have seen that if you will study both the provisions, there will be some difference between two. And these differences shall be the basically of the difference relating to the language of the legislation. And it says that as prescribed by the rules, format is there for writing the complaint. Therefore, if an expert lawyer is there and very easily he can do his practice in a good manner, in a legal manner, because he has the capacity of understanding. And that prescribed format is given under this rules, format 1, 2, 3 are there. For medical report also there is a format. For complaint there is a format. For protection order there is a format. For custody order there is a format. Every formats are there. Just like if you will see the schedule 2 of the CRPC, there are the formats. Summon the warrant and so on. All bail application format is there. And security to file the security undertaking, there is a format. In the same way, under the rules, whenever you have to study the legislation, PEACH means the enacted law, at once try to search the rules made there under. And all these things are complained, as you have seen, Siegel legal services, all these section 5, you have seen that the maintenance list of the service provider. One thing is that who will be the service provider, you will, because it requires to be clear here, the who will be, what will be qualification, and who will appoint the service provider, as you have seen, the protection officer. Service provider shall also be the appointed by the government, but there will not be any person of the government department. It has not written that there will not be, but there is no provision. Only provision is that if a person is working in non-governmental department, that organization is registered under the 1860 Act, Cooperative Society Act, and at the same time, he is working in a company and registered that company or that person is working, then certainly that will be the, of course, of the basically of the service provider. He will be the service provider. But service provider is under the protection officer. Whatever the services will be given to the victim, aggrieved party, that shall be given by the service provider. That is the point. And in the section 10 categorically says that there is no rule. His appointment or her appointment is given under section 10 in the enacted law procedure is given there, but the for the protection officer, the procedure is not given there. It has prescribed as prescribed, as prescribed. Meaning is there by that, whatever the rule says, and that will be applied in that matter. That is the thing. Then duty of the government, as I have highlighted yesterday also, this legislation is not in practically in full swing. It is not practically is being applied because of the various kinds of problem. I have stated, I have told yesterday, these are the problems. But it shall be the duty of the government to disseminate basically the information about this act, how it is possible, by way of the radio transmission, by way of television transmission, and by way of the newspaper publication, and by way of any other means. Section 11, duty of the state. This is the duty of the state that is requires to be done by the government. Then of course, very relevant section is, that is the section 12. Of course, section 4 says that the complaint shall be made by the protection officer. It has said, but the complaint application, it is prescribed under it is the section 12. And this is the new chapter number 4, and it starts from the 12 to goes up to the 29. It is very, very essential part of this legislation. It is very important part of this legislation to lodge the complaint, to issue the notice, to call the persons before the magistrate, to pass an order and to implement the order, and for filing the appeal. This is under chapter 4. It starts from that part, and that part is the section which starts from the section 12 to 29. Complaint format, you have seen one essential aspect is also there. We say that this should be the set of provision. Normally, if you want to appear in the judicial examination, this question of setup, which is the subject matter of the CPC, asked in the interview or in the examination question paper. Section 12, apart from the other provisions which are stated by the legislature from section 4 and 5 and so on, it is a separate that set off shall be there. Set off shall be there means if any compensation order passed initially by the magistrate and the defendant, means that accused, it is, of course, it is neither a civil law nor the criminal law, but the punishment is prescribed, the corporal punishment. 1 year punishment is there. 20,000 fine is there, or both is there, and that is for the respondent. At the same time, if the protection officer shall not perform his or her duty, and she and he is under liable to get the punishment also, protection officer. Therefore, corporal punishment is there. Procedure, somehow it has written the procedure according prescribed under the CRPC, but there is a controversy whether it is the civil or the criminal. Corporal punishment is there, but at the same time compensation provision is also there, and compensation is a subject matter of the civil law. Monetary relief is the subject matter of the civil law. Custody order is the subject matter of civil law. And property order can be given by the magistrate to reside in the same shelter in a separate portion, the property related subject matter is the civil law. Therefore, this is one of the aspect criminal as well as the civil relief. Both the reliefs are has been provided by the legislature to the victims here. And the point is that the set-off, as you have tried to understand what is the meaning of this set-off. Set-off means the adjustment of money which is already paid by the defendant, that is the accused respondent, in the initial order passed by the competent magistrate having the jurisdiction prescribed under this, the protection of women from the Domestic Violence Act. Then again section 3, see the section 13, that is again very very useful section, that when the complaint shall be lodged under section 12 before the magistrate, there will be a notice shall be issued to whom? That to the respondent. You know, because some participants or some students are practicing in the court, the notice shall be issued. But interestingly, the issue of notice is the subject matter of either the CPC or the CRPC. And the method of issuing the notice, at the same time, there is the one provision which is written under section 13 of this act, that the service of the notice shall assure by the protection officer before the court and shall submit one declaration. And one declaration is the declaration of that service has been served. Otherwise, way of the service of the notice is either the post office, registered, dark, or by electronic means, because after the 2000, after the enforcement of Information Technology Act, many provisions of the procedural law and the evidence has also been amended. This is one of the method, but this act says that it shall be the declaration shall be filed by the protection officer. Very interestingly, it has been served notice. Then again, after filing the complaint, as you know, under the matrimonial disputes, there is a provision for the appointment of counselor. Counselor is a person who will have the duty to ask both the parties in a same platform for compromise. In a simple word, it can be said the compromise. Therefore, who will appoint the counselor and who will become the counselor, who will what is the qualification of the counselor? Counselor shall be appointed by the magistrate, number one. And any person can become the counselor. But there is one rider, one condition. If any person is involved in a case, either he is defending or he is contesting the case as a lawyer, on behalf of the complainant or the respondent, he cannot become or she cannot become the counselor. It means the disqualification is prescribed under section 4 and rules made there under. But the qualification is very limited, and other part of this aspect is bigger than or powerful part of the law rather than the qualification, who cannot become. This is the speciality of the language of the legislature. Then assist of welfare expert or another person will be there under section 15. Welfare, who will look after the welfare of the aggrieved party, he will be called the welfare expert, shall be appointed by the magistrate under section 16. Now think over it, protection officer is for the protection of the aggrieved party, service provider is for the aggrieved party, third one you have seen the counselor is also there, and fourth is the basically the expert is one of the another person which will be appointed in favor or for the protection. It is a special kind of mechanism. Various persons are there for providing the safety, otherwise that was not possible. Even if there is a violence, no person is coming into the picture, any person apart from the complainant, any person can come forward for giving the information of the violence, and that person who will give the information, he is protected. His liability shall not be there. There shall not be any kind of the liability of that person. Very interestingly, even if it has not been written that if the information shall be the false and fabricated, truthness will not be there. The liability shall not be there, but it says that the protection officer, before lodging the complaint, shall assess the facts on the ground of reason to believe. And the definition, as I have stated, the definition of reason to believe as written under section 26 of Indian Penal Code. That is very essential. Then after this assistant welfare, and one more very useful and protective provision is also there. And that protective provision is prescribed under the section 16. But there are some conditions. And what is that protective procedure or protection or provision? That is that all the proceedings shall be in camera, but not all the times. The conditions are there. Number one, if the magistrate thinks fit means the discretion of the magistrate, and that is not a arbitrary discretion. It is a discretion based on the evidences. It shall be proper to proceed in the camera proceeding. Secondly, if the party shall request one of the party will request either the complainant or the respondent for the camera proceeding. Camera proceeding, you might be aware about the camera proceeding, please. I am not going to discuss here. A proceeding where the others will not enter, only the parties will be there, and the court will be there, and the other assistants who are required as per the provision of law, duly enacted law, only they will be there. It will not be called the open court. Otherwise, there is a procedure that every proceeding, every trial, and every the discussion of the court shall be in a open for. Camera provision is also there, because it is a matter related to the female. Then shared house shall be provided by order of the court. A shared house in the same room, same. There are the cases if the house is not in the name of the husband, it is in the name of the parents. Then Mute where that. It shall be?
Huh? Mute in your eye.
Please mute your mic. Don't disturb. Then these are the things: mic and video. Galaxy A5. Who is Galaxy A5? If you will disturb the, how I will take the classes? It requires to make the concentration. That is not good. Okay, there are the cases if the shelter is not in the name, or that shelter has been disposed of, or it is a rented house. Any kind of situation may be there. Then court has interpreted this section and laid down the principle. Even if it is a rented house, this one of the share for the residence shall be given by order of the magistrate to the aggrieved party. Of even if it has been sold out, the compensation or the cost shall be given to the aggrieved party. Yes, I will analyze, because the we are not getting the much time for the its analysis. And section 8 prescribes the duty of the magistrate by passing the protection order, as you have seen. Under which section? Under section 5. Section 18 again says that the protection order shall be passed by the magistrate. And what will be the subject matter of this protection office protection order? The subject matter means what should be passed by the magistrate, what shall be written on this protection order. There shall not be any kind of violation. Sorry, that there shall not be any kind of the violence. Number one, no abatement shall be there for the violence by any person of the member of the family or outside the family. If the child is there and that child is going to the school, no study shall be disturbed of the child. Child study shall not be disturbed by anyone. The cost shall be given by the respondent. That shall be written in the protection office, the protection order. No communication of threat shall be there. Any threat shall not be given. And if there is any accounts, joint account or account in the name of the female who is suffering of this violence, domestic violence, that shall be safely operated by the aggrieved party, or no withdrawal shall be made by the respondent if joint account is there. And the dependent of the complainant shall not be threatened by anyone. Residence order, as you have seen, that no one will be evicted or will say go out, means the person who is aggrieved shall not be disturbed to live in the house. This is called residence order. But only order of the magistrate if there will be any other law. Suppose it was the landlord's house and a litigation was before the court, before this domestic violence, then certainly that order shall apply if the eviction order shall be passed by the competent court in favor of landlord, but the compensation shall be given by the husband or by the person who is one of the party as a respondent. Okay, monetary relief, 20 and all these things are, and that monetary relief, how it will be calculated? Monetary relief means the relief for all the expenditures. How it will be calculated? There is a theory under the civil law, law of tort, if you will see, that the compensation. Compensation is the term under the civil law and subject matter of the law of tort. How it will be calculated? On the basis of earning all these things, but it is the duty of the magistrate. What will be the amount? And your understanding should be there on the basis of facts, evidences, income sources, dependent, own expenditure, age, status, you can argue before the court also. And this is the situation. Therefore, as it has been written under this section 5, the separate section for custody order is also there, 21, and compensation order 22. And one more important aspect for the practical purpose is there, that is the section 23. Normally, you are well aware about the provisions of CPC. It is expected, it is a presumption. You might be aware or you might not be, because you are not studying properly. And I hope that after taking the admission in LLM, especially of this special kind of institution, you will do the hard work relating to your study, whatever the liability may be there, I hope. And it is expected and it is a presumption that you may be aware that when the ex parte order can be passed by the court. This is the subject matter of CPC, but here also on under section 23, it has been written that the ex parte order shall be passed by the court. And when the ex parte order can be passed, it is again discretion of the magistrate. And the ground of passing the ex parte decision, if there is a likelihood, the dangerous, it can be there in future, the ex parte decision shall be passed. And for getting the ex parte decision from the court of first class magistrate, there is one requirement. And that requirement says that affidavit shall be filed by the complainant of this intention that there is a dangerous and a harm may be committed by the respondent where she is living in the same center. Then ex parte decision without giving any hearing to the respondent may be passed. Another special kind of provision under section 24 says that the copies of the order of the court shall be provided to the complainant. Complainant means applicant. It is written that the applicant without any cost. To the applicant written. It means the respondent will not get the copy free of cost from the court, but the applicant will get it. And free of cost, the order shall be given to the police also by the court. This is special. Service provider is also entitled to get it. The service provider will see that whether there is any kind of the danger for the life of the complainant or other services shall be provided. That is the duty of the service provider. And one another legal aspect, that when this case shall be discharged from the court, of course there is the time, as I have said, that the within the 6 month case shall be disposed of. So far the discharge is totally different. It is a subject matter of CRPC again. Conviction and discharge. A person cannot be discharged unless there will be the inherently dangerous to the life of the complainant. He will not be discharged. Free from charge, he will not be there. This is also there. Then jurisdiction where the case can be filed. Because in CPC you have seen, in CRPC you have seen where the case can be filed. There are the chapters. Please, the usefulness of this lecture means go at home, then immediately try to study the provisions of CPC and CRPC. We are just discussing the procedural aspect of this law and correlating it with the procedural law. 27 says that where either the party resides at the time of this dispute, where their business is there, and where there was the cause of action, it is a special law. Therefore, the CPC provisions are also written under this law. Where the complaint, it is a word complaint. You will say that, sir, under CRPC also there is the provision for filing the complaint for the PT cases. I agree. But some provisions are here related to this CPC. And of course, it is written that under section 28 for the purpose of this, from section 18 up to the section 23, the procedural law as prescribed under the CRPC shall be applied. It is written. See the structure of the legislation, very interesting structure. And appeal, I have discussed yesterday, 29 and 1 month and before the session court, that is here. But another chapter is there. This is the last part, chapter 5, which is called the miscellaneous. And the punishment is prescribed under this chapter. And it starts from section 30 and goes up to the 37. And 37 is rulemaking power. Rulemaking means where the rules request to be made by the executive, written under section 37. Under this section, where it is written that prescribed means rule it shall be made. I have expressed. Try to understand very in easy language. I am just narrating the things. But the section 30 says that it requires to analyze the protection officer and service provider and others shall be the public servant for the purpose of this section 21 of the Indian Penal Code. What is the meaning of this public servant? And what is the purpose? Why it is written so? It means if you will see the 21 public servant, One side, there is a protection to the public servant, because in Indian Penal Code, there is one chapter, the function and to at the time of performing the function and duties, the protection is given to the public servant. And in violation and in breach of the duty, or in interference by other persons, then some FIR can be lodged against those persons who has interfered into the affairs of the public servant. This is one side. Another side, why it is written under section 30, they are public servant, that if they will commit any corruption, and a protection officer who have the duty, a service provider who have the duty, will manipulate the things, then another side is to prosecute to them under the Prevention of Corruption Act. A public servant is the subject matter of this law also. Then penalty for the breach and not to perform the protection order issued by the magistrate. There is a provision. It shall not be followed, and then physical punishment to the respondent. It is the duty of respondent. And it is 22 say that it is a cognizable offense, although there is only the punishment of 1 year. And if you will see the schedule of the CRPC, schedule 1, normally above the 2 years punishment, they are cognizable, these are cognizable and non-bailable. But punishment is less, and it is a cognizable, means the police can take the cognizance without taking the warrant from the magistrate directly. And it is non-bailable. You know better than my assessment that what is the impact of non-bailable, how it can be said so. Then same, if the protection officer shall not perform the duty, punishment is to the protection officer also. And the one aspect we say that if any public servant prescribed under this law comes under the functions performed by them in good faith, they are protected. They are normally protected. Then the record, of course, I will try to 37, of course, this is the part, but I am just the record is available that the